In this video, we're looking at wireless and mobile network security. Now, in your facility, you're probably seeing more and more wireless. If you have not deployed wireless network already, that is something I would foresee you probably doing in the next couple years. With wireless, it has a great advantage because people can just be mobile. Some facilities you're going to see don't even have physical offices that their people are setting in anymore. They're allowing them to be able to move around, freeform, moving within their facility. Some advantages of wireless also is the cost of cabling. It used to be that wireless was a fairly expensive thing to install. Nowadays, wireless access points are fairly cheap and fairly easy to set up. Now, business grade access points can handle a lot more than a home network. Home networks, you're not going to have them managed. You're going to have individual devices for your home. For a business, you probably have what's called a managed wireless network, where you have a central repository where they're all interconnected and allowing for a certain amount of connection and remote management on them. That is something you're going to see within your facility. Now, within mobile, also we're looking at more and more devices that are having 4G capabilities. That way, if you have clients that are out on the job site or employees that are out on the job site, they can still interact with your network. So we got to look at the security and what comes into play with that. Now, first off, with wireless security, let's look at a term called rogue access points. You need to know what devices are on your network and what's happening with them. If you've taken the time to go through and configure your different access points, now what you need to do is you need to be sure there are not ones that you do not know about. So you need to be sure your employees are not plugging in their own access points, because those might just be wide open, so then anybody can gain access to your network. You need to be sure to lock everything down. Now, I want to talk you through a little bit about locking down a network. The pictures I'm going to be showing you are going to be based off of a home network device and what we're doing to set up at a home access point. Now, within our home, we're logging into the access panel on our actual device. Be careful about this. Just be sure you log in. Usually on the back of the device itself or on the CD itself, it's going to give you directions on how to log into the access to the administration panel on that device. Now, first thing here, wireless settings, we're looking at our network name, our SSID, or service set identifier. Watch out for that name. Don't change it to something that just really gives you away. Rondo for my house, I wouldn't want to name that. I would want some kind of obscure name where I know what it is, the people in my house know what it is, but somebody driving by is not going to realize, hey, that's where Chris lives, just based off of my SSID. So that's one option there. Now, notice down at the bottom of the screen, I don't have it highlighted, but it says wireless SSID broadcast, enable or disable. Enabled makes it visible. For your home network, I would encourage you to disable it. There's really no need to broadcast it, and that gives you just an extra layer of security. At your business, if you have a public-facing Wi-Fi that you want your clients to be able to connect to, then you want to enable it. That's what allows it to be visible. When you go to Starbucks or when you go to a business and you see their Wi-Fi turned on, that's the reason why you see it, is they have it enabled. They could have another network that's disabled, so you don't see it unless you know where it's at. So that's something you need to consider. I would encourage you to change that. One of the first things I would change on my access point when I'm setting it up. Another thing I want to look at is the actual security on the router itself. Here we're looking at the router password, with the router password, by default, it has password. It may be 1234, but it doesn't matter. At this window right here, you can see that I'm looking at a Linksys access point. I can simply go to Google and do a search for Linksys access points and what are their default passwords. I can get the username and password very easily to log into anybody's access point just from a simple Google search. So take the time, change this password, change it to something that you're going to know, have it written down somewhere, or maybe even not a good idea, but maybe tape it to the bottom of your access point for you don't forget how to log back in. But this way you don't have people remotely trying to access your access point. Now, the taping on the bottom of it, that might be an idea for at your house, probably not the best idea for a business, but this is kind of an example there for you, but definitely change this password. Next thing we want to look at is looking at the actual security that you have set up on it. Here we can see that they have a WPA2 personal. We can look at different levels of encryption. Definitely want to have something turned on. You don't want to just be broadcasting out in plain text. If you're broadcasting out with no security, anybody can see the information that's being broadcast. Do a quick search for videos on Wireshark. It is a packet capture tool. And if you're not running encryption, then if we're using Wireshark, we're seeing exactly what you're sending out there. Now, under the security mode, you're probably going to see a couple different options. You're going to see one of the old school ones, WEP, wireless equivalent privacy. Don't use that one. That one's really easy to break. What I tell my students in my physical class is that E in wireless equivalent privacy, pretend that E stands for easy to break. It's only a 64-bit key, so if you're using a tool like Wireshark, you're going to pick up that repetition really quickly. Anything within security, when there's repetition, that's what you're looking for in order to break that code. So WEP, I would encourage you just to not even try to use it. WPA, with WPA, it's definitely a better choice. It's not as secure as some of your other choices nowadays, but it's still better. It's double the key length. We're having a 128-bit key here, so providing more security. Go ahead and switch over to WPA2 though. What we're looking at is we're seeing that progression from TKIP to AES, so different levels of encryption and how they can impact our security. So I would look at, personally, I'd probably use WPA2 with AES. Now, be careful with your devices. If you're running some legacy wireless devices, you may need to bring your security down a notch because they may not be able to connect to a device with higher security. So legacy devices are something that we have to take in consideration whenever we're setting up our network also. Now, those are kind of the basic things that I would say to look at just by default setting up your access point. Quick, easy things, adjust your SSID, adjust your admin login to your actual device, and be sure you have a WPA2 encryption running, if not stronger. Play with TKIP and AES if you have different legacy devices. Now, looking at this screen, you can see there's other things we can go through and adjust. You can see there's wireless MAC filter. There's other things we can tweak. Take time to play through, do some reading on what all you need to set up. The wireless MAC filter is something I'd also probably encourage you to go through and play with. I did not do a screenshot of that, but that one allows you to register the different MAC addresses of the devices. So that way, if the device is not listed in that MAC filter list, it won't even allow a connection. So that is another way to go through and provide a little bit of extra security for you. So good things to play with. Now, the last thing that I want to look at in this video is looking at Boyd, bring your own device. Now, with Boyd, this is going to be something you're going to encounter more and more in your businesses, and I actually already referenced it in a previous video. Now, with Boyd, it stands for bring your own device, and it's something that we're going to see in businesses. How does it impact your facility? First off, what if somebody brings a device in? Do you allow them to connect it to your network? Who owns the device with the data on it? You have secure data now on a personal device, then if they leave your facility, who owns that device? So be sure your security policies are written very clearly with it. Is it more cost effective for your business? If I can get my employees to bring in their own laptops and use it for the business, then it's more cost effective for me because I'm not having to spend the money on a laptop or a desktop from them. So different considerations that you need to take, and I want to give you just a couple seconds to read over the screen and see what else you can see on here and how it might impact you. Okay, now one of the things you might need to consider with bringing your own device, be sure you have the network capacity to handle it. The wireless infrastructure you're going to need, you need to be sure it's boosted up heavy enough to handle all these extra devices that people might be bringing in. So kind of as a wrap up, look at securing your access points when you're setting them up, both home and business. A lot of access points you're going to go to your store, Office Depot, Best Buy, things like that. They're going to have some out-of-the-box encryption now already set up, which is a good thing. They used to come off the shelf wide open where you just plug it in and start using it. Nowadays, they're actually going to have you type in a password or something as you're getting going. But don't rely on that default because that is a default that people can research and find online. So be sure to set up your security. Look at bring your own device, both for you as a consumer. Are you going to be able to take your own devices to your job site? And as an employer, are you going to allow people to bring their devices to your job site? Hope you found this video helpful and informative. And if there's any other questions you have on it, do a little bit of research. You will see some more information on Boyd and how it's going to impact your businesses. And look at with your access points at your house. I would also encourage you, I didn't show you a screenshot of it, but I would encourage you to go back in and do a little bit of research on the MAC filtering and how that can improve the security for your home network. Hope you found this video helpful. Have a good day.